In today's video, I have 10 Easter Zoom game ideas for you. Easter is just around the corner, and I know you all are planning fun activities, parties, games for your students, family, and friends. If we are meeting for the first time, hi, my name is Shawn. Welcome on this channel. I'm bringing back family fun, one game at a time. Yeah. The first game is called Roll a Bunny. Each player will need their own die and access to the annotation tools on Zoom. If you don't know how to use the annotation tools, I do have a tutorial showing you how to use them. I will link that video in the description box down below. The Zoom host will assign a number to each part of the bunny, and on the count of 1, 2, 3, go, all players will begin rolling their die, and as their die lands on a number, they will draw that part of the bunny. Whoever draws the complete bunny first wins the game. Game idea number two is a virtual Easter egg hunt using the space around you. Set up your phone as a secondary camera on Zoom, like a secondary person. Hide Easter eggs around in your background, in the space that you are filming in your house. Take your camera around and show the space. Players will either have to count the number of eggs that they see or write down a description of the location of the eggs in chat. So say they see an egg on a bookshelf, they will write egg in a bookshelf. Then the Zoom host will tell everyone to submit their answers, and whoever has the correct answer wins the Easter egg hunt. Game idea number two is called Eggs in a Basket. Basically, this game is hangman, but we're not hanging anybody. We're doing Easter baskets. Using the annotation tools, draw an Easter basket, and however many eggs you put in the basket is how many guesses the players will get. You could have this vary every time you play a round of Eggs in a Basket. The Zoom host, or the first player, will pick a word. You could pick the word spring. Put your dashes for the letters in spring on your whiteboard. Players take turns guessing a letter, and the letters that they get incorrect go into the eggs in the basket. When all the eggs have been filled, then they have run out of time, and either everybody guesses the word or nobody wins. The next game idea is one of my personal favorites, involving a paper plate. If you've watched any of my videos, you know where I'm going with this. Yes, draw it paper plate. Every player will need a paper plate and a writing utensil. Instruct players to place their paper plate on top of their head and draw the Easter bunny on their paper plate on top of their head. Set a time limit of 30 seconds to 1 minute, and when the time is up, everybody will show their paper plates and all players will judge who drew the best Easter bunny, and that person is the winner. The next game is called Five Things. You are going to give your players a category, and they have to write down five things that fit into that category on a sheet of paper or in chat. Now, don't press send yet. Once everybody has their five things in the chat or on their paper, then the Zoom host will instruct everybody to send their answers, and you'll need to have all the players need to compare each other's answers to see how many are the same in the category. So say the category is five yellow things. If other players in the group have the sun, then you would mark out that name. And whoever has the most unique items in their list of five things is the winner. And you may have more than one winner for that round. And then you could do a second elimination round until you only have one winner left. Some examples of categories are five spring things, five yellow things, five characters in the Easter story, five things you'd find in an Easter basket. The next game is called the game, and this is another of my personal favorites. The game is a great game because you can put a spring or Easter spin on it. So for example, pick one player to stand up and they have to tell the entire Easter story in 1 minute without saying or If they do, they are eliminated. Then the next player gets up. They too have to tell the Easter story without saying or in 1 minute. And if they get farther than the previous person, then they are the current winner. Go through all the players until someone has gone the longest without saying or then that player is the winner. The next game idea is called Easter Movie. As the Zoom host, go ahead and queue up some images that you've pulled off of Google from Easter movies and load them up into Zoom under the virtual background option. Then when you play this game, change your background to reflect the Easter movie, and players type in chat what movie they think it is. The first person to guess correctly wins that round. Play as many rounds as you want with as many Easter movies as you can find. The next game idea is called Odd One Out. Before your Zoom call, as a Zoom host, create a list of 10 to 12 items that all have something in common, except for one. Make sure one of those items has nothing in common with all the others. Show your list using the screen share option. Players must then race to type in chat which item in the category is the odd one out, which one doesn't belong, which one doesn't fit. They will type that in chat. Then the Zoom host will tell everyone to submit their answers all at the same time so that there are no cheaters. The players that guess the odd one out correctly go on to the next elimination round. The next game idea is called My Favorite Things. These are a few of my favorite things. Poll players ahead of time to get their most favorite thing, their one favorite thing in a list of categories. Categories could be favorite Easter candy, favorite spring flower, favorite spring break vacation spot, favorite jelly bean flavor. Then show the top two answers on the screen side by side. You could use screen share or you could type in chat and have players guess which one of the two things was everybody's most favorite. Like which one was the most popular thing. Or if you have the paid version and can do polls on Zoom, this would work even better because you could play this game instantly on the spot using the poll feature, have players guess what they think was the top answer for everybody. The last game is called What's Missing, and this is a spring version of my classic What's Missing game that you all loved during the Christmas holidays. Thank you so much again for all of the love that you showed this game back in Christmas. I've made a spring version. It is available on my website, but it's a guessing game. You see a bunch of spring objects on the screen, and then one of those objects is taken away, and players have to guess which object went missing, and they rack up points. Whoever has the most points at the end of 10 rounds of gameplay wins the game. This game is available on my website. I'll post it in the description box down below. Thanks for watching today's video, and I will see you in the next one. Happy Easter!